my name is Taylor. If you guys are new, and I am back and better with another video. Today is my 20th birthday. I'm already dressed. I'm wearing this really, really cute, I don't know what this is called, but it goes around your neck. And it's a pink dress that I got literally from Target for only $15. So it was really, really affordable, but this kind of got wet. Right now, I'm currently getting ready. It is about 10:20-ish, and I plan to leave my house at 11, but I don't know if that'll happen because I did kind of sleep in a little bit longer than I wanted to. I slept past my alarm because, I don't know, I've been wearing my retainers lately because I have braces, if you guys didn't know, and my teeth are shifting a little bit. Not only that, they're shifting a little bit, and since I haven't worn the retainers in a long time, it's very painful to wear. My bottom ones hurt really bad. The top ones go in, they just feel really tight and a little bit painful. But they fit. So I've been wearing the top ones a lot lately just to kind of get my teeth back used to it so that I don't, you know, basically mess up my teeth, because I did have dental work done. I had braces for about a year and a half, and I don't want to, like, I don't know. My goal this year is to take better care of my teeth and stuff. So I really wanted to start wearing my retainers more. So I think like Monday is when I started wearing them, and yeah, so they hurt. And so I was up kind of early. This morning, I was up at like 5 a.m. because of the pain, and then I decided to just go ahead and take the retainer out because I went to bed at like 12 and then woke up at 5. So I kept the retainers in, I watched some shows, and then at around 7, that's when I just decided to go ahead and take it out because I feel like my body's gonna rest more and I will be able to get a good night's sleep if I took it out. So that's why I took it out. And then after that, like, girl, I was asleep for about an hour and a half because I wasn't feeling any pain, so my body was just at rest. And yeah, I slept good the last few hours, but kind of sleepy. All I need to do now is just wash my face, put a little bit of makeup on. I'm gonna show you guys everything that I'm gonna be using when I come back. And then I also need to go ahead and lay my edges and stuff because they're just a little bit frizzy. You know, I'm just gonna slick them back inside the braid like that so that they're not looking crazy. Because they do kind of get wet, and of course I'm sweating every single day that I'm out. I'm about to go in with my moisturizer by Aveeno. I just cleansed my skin with my cleanser. I'm trying to take better care of my skin too this year because I feel like I went through a lot of breakouts. I've been watching a lot of skincare tips and tricks on TikTok, and so I'm hoping to, you know, just get like my acne that I have under control. Well, not acne, I don't really have acne, but you know, every now and then I do break out, and most of the time it has a lot to do with the foods that I eat, but it can also be me not washing my face at night before I go to bed, you know, just stuff like that, not putting on my moisturizer every day, because this is SPF moisturizer, which basically protects your skin from the sun. And the one that I use, the Aveeno Positively Radiant one, this also fades dark marks. So if you do deal with dark marks on your face, this definitely helps, because I had a mark on my chin. It's fading, but I had a mark on my chin from a huge pimple that I had, and it faded in literally 2 days after using this moisturizer, because I had to go back and buy it because I hadn't used it for a while. It's pretty expensive. It's like, this thing is $16, but it works. I don't even know if I'm doing this in the right order, but I'm gonna go ahead and put on my serum that I got. I literally just bought this at Ulta. It's the Good Molecules Hyaluronic Acid Serum. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put this on my face. One drop, two drops, one on my forehead. Hopefully this don't break me out, but we'll see. This is supposed to bring moisture into your skin. Oh my gosh, what is this? Now that I put that serum on, oh, it feels really good. And it looks good too. Like, I don't see any dry patches or flakes right now. So we're gonna hope that it stays like that. And then I really don't like this primer. It's the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Soft Silk Hydrating Primer. And I feel like my face just doesn't have a good reaction to it when I use this. It doesn't, I don't know, I just feel like every time I use it, there's a pimple that pops up on my face. And so, since it is my birthday and my face is clear right now, I don't feel like I'll break out today. If anything, I'll break out tomorrow. But I do need to invest in a better primer or something that's just something that's not this. I need to buy something else because this ain't gonna work. I can't be trying to look cute, trying to put on makeup, and then just messing up my face every single time. So I really do not like this primer at all. I don't know why I still have it in my freaking makeup bag, but this is all I have for right now. Always see videos on TikTok talking about how skincare is basically the foundation for having good makeup and stuff, and so that's why I really want to start I really want to start getting more into makeup. I don't wear makeup because I've always had just breakouts and I've never found a good cleanser. Now that I have a set routine, I have a good face cleanser that I'm using, and I also have a good moisturizer, and now that I have that as my set products, now I can start to try out serums and stuff. And I've always heard good things about the Good Molecules Hyaluronic Acid Serum, so that's why I'm trying that out. But I always see people saying, yeah, make sure that your skincare is good because that's gonna make your makeup look good. And so, yeah, ever since I saw videos like that, that's what I just really wanted to prioritize skincare more and just take better care of it, because I feel like my makeup always looks patchy. I don't know, I remember on my graduation day, this was back in 2020, on my graduation day, I didn't have a good primer. I literally just put makeup on my face, didn't put nothing on it before. And hold on, I'm using my Rare Beauty concealers for my foundations. But yeah, I put nothing on my skin before I put on my foundation, and I just remember my forehead looking so crusty. Basically back then on that day, if you were to come up to my face and look closely at it, you would see a whole bunch of dry patches on my face, on my forehead. So yeah, ever since then I'm like, no, I don't know how to do makeup, so let me just not. But now that I'm trying to get more into it, it's like I found out that you're supposed to like moisturize, use a serum and a primer before putting on your foundation or concealer to make sure your skin is smooth. So I'm gonna start doing that more because I feel like that's gonna help me with my little patches that I get with foundations. But I think it was because I was using the Fenty foundation, and that one is she has a matte one and a hydrating one, and I was using her matte one, and the matte one basically mattifies your face, so you have to have a good hydrating primer if you have dry skin, and I have dry skin. So I have normal to dry skin. It's like combo, it's a mix. But I'm using my Rare Beauty concealer. This is in the number 380. And then the lighter one that I'm using to kind of blend it all out is the 240. When I mix them, it makes the perfect color. Y'all probably like, girl, what are you doing? You know what you're doing. But this is just what I do, and I'm gonna just stick to this. So the final look, I need to go ahead and put these clothes in my hamper because my friend may be coming over. She may be coming over, and I got chair clothes. Clothes on my chair are clean, but they're probably gonna go in the dirty basket for now because I don't have any hangers right now. And yeah, it's kind of a hot mess in here, but well, it's not that bad. My bed is made, which makes everything look clean. And then most of everything is picked up off my floor. Hopefully I don't look too clownish. I'm gonna go ahead and put on some perfume. And it's between YSL Libre Intense and Valentino Donna Born Aroma. I don't really know which one I wanna wear. They both smell really good, and they're both very, very long-lasting, but I'm leaning more towards this one just because it just smells so expensive. Like, I just love how it smells. They both smell expensive. This one's floral. They're both floral, but this one has more of a vanilla base and a more muskiness to it, and it's more clean-smelling. This one's more fruity, heavy fruity and floral. And then I'll probably freshen up later because I am changing outfits before we go out later tonight. Okay, now I need to go ahead and sweep these edges.
So I'm here with Yasmin. Hi. And she's in the front for today because the door is partially fixed. It's not completely fixed, but it's partially fixed. So you can kind of open it and close it. Yeah. You can leave it open.
Oh, I leave it open?
If you want.
Oh, it's about to go.
It is hot. It's hot. It is about 100 some degrees. But we're about to go ahead and go into this mall and find the Stranger Things Museum. And I'm going to see if I can get some good photos and take y'all along with me. So let's go.
Hopefully it don't be so packed.
Yeah, because we weren't able to secure a spot. Yeah, reserve a spot. Because it was packed, it was full. The list was full to reserve a spot, so you had to be on this wait list. Mm-hmm. But it is a walk-in museum, so even if you didn't reserve a spot, you can still walk in and see all the rooms and stuff that they have in there. So I'm really excited because I've never been to this museum before, and
we love Stranger Things.
The new season comes out next week on July 1st. Best believe I will be watching it after I get off work and before. So yeah, let's go ahead and go see if this line is long or not. If it's long, we might just go and look for my rewards, my free stuff. But we might as well just stay in the line though, because
also that
we don't want to lose a spot.
I was gonna say, even if it's packed like that, because our mm-hmm. first choice was to go bowling, and they have a round one in here.
If the line is extremely long, like where it just looks unnecessary to even stand in, then the backup plan is just round one.
So we're in line right now. It's about a 35 minute wait.
Yeah.
So
it's not that bad. We're like almost up there.
Yeah, we're almost up there. This is how many people are in front of us. So
let's show them the back.
That's Joyce's room. The Star Court Mall's over there.
Nancy?
Nancy can wear stuff like this.
Girl! Because it's black, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is cute. Oh, it's kind of basic. That's cute too. They might have some cute stuff in here. Oh, that's a cute shirt.
I didn't see any shirt that I liked.
Did you see anything you liked?
We seen a shirt that we liked, but it was that
it was kids. It was a kid size, and I wanted their, I wanted all the Stranger Things characters' faces on the front of the shirt, but they only had it on the back of the shirt.
And just say Stranger Things. That's it.
Yeah, but they didn't have that.
Their pictures, so I didn't want it. They had like makeup palettes and stuff.
Yeah,
and
I told you to get it, but she didn't want to get it. I don't know why. Why didn't you get it?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I just felt like it wasn't enough. It was only $19.
But you wanted a shirt too, though. That's what you really wanted. I feel like you were gonna get that shirt too. The one that we liked. Yeah. So I got my free pretzel and my free Cinnabon, and now we're on our way to go to Sephora so I can get my free gift and Chick-fil-A to get my free nuggets or sandwich.
So you went to breakfast or something, though.
Girl, I was sleep in bed.
I know.
Okay, so we are leaving the mall. Well, we're not leaving the mall. We want to go to round one, but
Should
we both have. Call them.
Yeah, I'm gonna call them.
Okay, okay. We're going to round one because we want to see if they have any socks that we could wear because we have sandals on. But we left the Stranger Things Museum early because we didn't buy anything, and there was only like five little parts in the store where you could take pictures and stuff. And it didn't take long. It wasn't as packed inside the store because there's a line outside, so they're only letting a minimum amount of people in at once. So we left pretty early. We were probably in there for like, what, 30 minutes, and then we left. And I got my Auntie Anne's free pretzel, my Cinnabon, and now we wanna go to round one. Well, I wanna go to round one. I've been wanting to go. She's been wanting to go too because I suck at bowling, and I wanna practice, and I wanna get better at it. So I wanna go bowling today. And we pretty much do have some time. I mean, we don't have to leave until 4, so we can make our way back so I can change, and then we're gonna go out to dinner with my family. So we're on our way to round one. It's literally right around the corner because they have a round one at this mall. So now we're at round one. We're about to go bowling. I haven't been in forever. I hope y'all can hear me. But hopefully it's not packed. I'm gonna try and get one game in for 30 minutes. So you get your own shoes at this little shoe thing, and it's so cool. Yeah. That's so cool. I just got mine over here, but I love that. They don't do this at Alley Cats. Where's the socks at? Okay, so we got our names up there, and I think I'm first, so I'm about to go. You'll be guaranteed to hit something. Yeah, don't do it too hard though. Do it like soft. Come up more. No, come up more. Come up closer. Then do it. Yeah, that's what I do. Yeah. 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 Hey. I know you're gonna get something. That's what I do. Come up closer. Yes, ma'am.
It's okay. I can't even talk.
lighting. Ooh, I should take more pictures and stuff. But we did get, you did get some good pictures of me.
Oh, yeah, I did.
But we're leaving the boat. Oh, send me those pictures we took at,
I will.
Yeah. So we're leaving round one and we're about to head back to my side of town to just hang out. You get to see my room and everything like that. And then I need to change. Oh yeah, we gonna see if my dog barks at her. And then I need to change into my jumper. But yeah. That's fine, yeah. But we're gonna take more pictures tonight at the Sugar Factory, and I cannot wait, because I haven't posted on Instagram in like a year. Well, since November. And so, yeah, it's freaking hot, oh my gosh. We're gonna head back to my house, and then we're gonna go to the Sugar Factory and have some more fun, and eat some good food, and everything like that. So I'm looking forward to it. And we're actually pretty early. It's only 3:30, and my mom wanted me to start driving back to my side of town around 4. So we could do something else. I don't know what else we would do. But we could have played 2 games because it only took us 30 minutes to play 1 game.
But I feel like it was good.
It was pretty cool. It was chill.
At least, I mean, by the time we get home, it takes, from here,
it's 30 minutes. So when we get home, it'll be 4 o'clock, and we'll have like an hour and 30 minutes to like chill.
Chill and hang.
Yeah. So let's go.
We're going to have to leave again.
Yeah, we're leaving because the reservations at Sugar Factory is 5:30. It takes 45 minutes to get to Sugar Factory from my house.
Okay.
So like an hour. We'll be leaving probably like an hour early or something like that. We might leave at 5. Because it restaurants are 5:30, we're leaving probably at 5. So it's good that we're making good timing. Did you want to go to Chick-fil-A right now?
Girl,
or you wait? You wanna wait?
I don't want to eat.
Okay. You're not gonna eat your cinnamon roll?
No, I'm not, like, that's the thing. Like, I'm not, like, that drink filled me up.
Oh yeah, she had a coffee from Cinnabon.
So like, I'm not too hungry. I wanna save my appetites for later.
Yeah. Okay, but we're gonna head to the house and we'll see you guys in a minute. From the Sugar Factory, and it was really good. If you live in the DFW area, then you have to go to Dallas and go to the Sugar Factory. It was so much fun. The food was good. I got a steak with, well, they gave me steak with rice and then yams, but I wanted steak with a loaded mashed potato and broccoli. So they didn't bring out my right thing, but then we called the waiter back, and then he ended up bringing it later on, like 20 minutes after I already got my steak. He brought out my sides that I wanted, but I wanted to substitute the sides that are already on the menu for the loaded mashed potatoes and broccoli, and I guess his boss wouldn't let him do it. It was weird, but I ended up getting my food and stuff later on. I got this huge drink. I'll insert pictures. I got this huge drink. It was a non-alcoholic drink because I'm only 20. I'm not 21, but it was good. It was a strawberry lemonade
type of drink. It almost tasted like Sprite mixed with strawberry and lemonade because it had this fizziness to it that I really, really liked. So I had that drink and then I had my food. And then at the end, they brought out all this, they brought out this huge bowl of ice cream with a whole bunch of stuff in it. I mean, it was a mixture of strawberry, cookies and cream, chocolate, all together. And it was so good. And then they had toppings of sprinkles, Oreos, Reese's peanut butter toppings. They had whipped cream, gummy bears. There's just a whole bunch of things inside the ice cream. Cookie dough, chocolate chip, just a whole bunch of stuff. It was really, really good. So we had that and they sang happy birthday. Well, they didn't sing happy birthday. They came out, and what's really funny about Sugar Factory is that the waiters, they dance. The waiters and waitresses, they come out and they dance, and you can pick a song on a list. And so everybody was doing Savage by Megan Thee Stallion, and because it was a lot of birthdays. Every 5 minutes, the waiters and waitresses were coming out dancing with this huge sign that said happy birthday with your name on it. And it was really, really cool and neat how they did it. So everybody was doing Savage by Beyonce and Megan Thee Stallion, or Savage by Megan Thee Stallion featuring Beyonce. They were doing Up by Cardi B. What's another song they were doing? They were doing something else that was really popular that they kept doing. And so I just chose Level Up by Ciara because nobody was doing that one, and it's an upbeat song. Like, you can level up, hey, level up, level up. So I knew that this boy who was coming out, he has so much energy. It was one of the waiters. He has so much energy, and I knew that if I chose that song, he'd be like this, and I was right, and I was so happy because his energy just made me so happy, and it made my night. So yeah, and y'all will see that video of that as well. But it was a really, really, really fun night and good day as well with my friend, because I hung out with her earlier, and then later on that night we went out to eat with family. So it was really, really cool, y'all. I really enjoyed it. I got raccoon eyes. I'm gonna have to wash my face after this because my makeup isn't completely off, and I don't want to break out. So, because like I said, y'all, I'm really trying to get better with skincare and take better care of my skin. And this makeup wipe is definitely not getting everything off. But I really hope y'all enjoyed my video today. I really hope you guys go to Sugar Factory if you have one in your area, because it's really, really cool. And it was packed though. It was packed, I will say that. It's a really popular spot. But I think it was because of the fact that today was a Saturday and a lot of people were out on the weekends. But I'm about to go ahead and go to bed. Like this video, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.